See this question. We need to find the mean precipitation by using Thiessen's polygon method. This is the total catchment area, and 6 stations are given for this catchment area. As you can see here, A, it is the precipitation value at the station A is 4.8 cm. For station B, it is 13 cm. For station C, it is 8 cm. For station D, it is 5.4 cm. For station E, here it is 3.2 cm, and for F it is 9.4 cm. As you can see, it is given in the question, the area of the catchment is composed of square. This is the square A, B, C, D. This is the square plus an equilateral triangle. Here A, E, D is the equilateral triangle. Plot of side 4 km means each side of this square A, B, C, D and the triangle A, E, D is 4 km. So we know the Thiessen's polygon method, that is the summation of precipitation into area divided by summation of area. Now we need to find the respective areas concerned with the stations. So see here how to find the areas. As you can see, in order to find the respective area, we need to follow this process. Now see this diagram. At first, we need to connect all the stations. From this point F, first connect to A. Again from F, connect to B. From F, connect to C. And from F, connect to D. Then bisect the square. As you can see, this is the midpoint of this line AB. This is the midpoint of the line BC. This is the midpoint of the line CD. And this is the midpoint of the line AD. After bisecting it, connect these points like this. Then using perpendicular bisector drawn from the sides of the triangle so as to obtain the respective area of each station. Here also, using perpendicular bisector, we will divide the equilateral triangle in 3 equal areas. As you can see, this is the midpoint here, this is the midpoint here of this line, this, and this is the midpoint here of AD. We will connect this point in this way. Now we have got the respective areas. Now we will calculate the values. Now see here, this is the larger square. We know the area of square formula, that is side square. Here one side is 4 km. So what will be the value? As you can see, area of the larger square, that is the side square, equal to 4 into 4, that is 16 km square. Now here the bisector have formed this smaller square. We know since this is the midpoint, this will divide this line in 2 equal half, that is 2 km and 2 km. Again, this midpoint will divide this line in 2 equal half, that is 2 km and 2 km. So this is 2 km and this is 2 km. So using Pythagoras theorem, we will find out this line. The value of this line will be 2 root 2. So since it is the side of the smaller square, again for square the formula will remain same to find the smaller square, that is side square. 2 root 2 into 2 root 2, that will be 8 km square. Now this is the larger square and this is the smaller square. Apart from this, we have left with this part, this part, this part, this part. So subtracting the area of smaller square from the larger square, we will get these shaded areas. So as you can see here, area of this shaded portion, we have four equal areas for the shaded portion. So area of the shaded portion is area of the larger square minus the smaller square, that we got as 8 kilometer square. So as we have four parts, what will be the area of one part? So dividing area of the shaded portion by 4, we got area of one shaded portion as 2 kilometer square. Now coming to the equilateral triangle, we know the area of equilateral triangle is root 3 by 4 into side square. We know here side is 4 kilometers, so root 3 by 4 into side square, that is 4 into 4. Here 1/4 will be cut by this 4. We have root 3 into 4, and multiplying this root 3 into 4, we got 6.93. so again the equilateral triangle is divided into 3 equal parts. So dividing this value here, 6.93 by 3, we got 2.31, that is area of one portion of the equilateral triangle. So here I have calculated all the value of the different areas. Now as you can see, this station A is connected to this area and this area. For this station B, this is the respective area. Similarly for station C, this is the respective area, and for D it is same as A. This station is connected with this area, shaded portion of this, and one part of this equilateral triangle. And station E is connected to this area, and F is connected to this area, the smaller square. So see this table. I have written all the six stations here, values of the precipitations as given, and the areas. For station 1, as I have already explained, for this station A, the area of this portion is 2 kilometer square, then the area of this portion is 2.31, so total will be 2 plus 2.31, that is 4.31. so respective area for station A is 4.31. for station B, that is station 2, this portion area is 2 kilometer square, so similarly I have written 2 here. Then for station 3, this station C, this is the respective area, that is 2 kilometer square. Similarly 2 is written here. For the fourth station, that is station D, this is 2 kilometer square, and this area is 2.31, summation of 2 plus 2.31, that is 4.31, as you can see here. This station E, that is 5, this area is 2.31, one part of the equilateral triangle, so this is 2.31. and finally we have the last station, that is this station F6. This area of square is 8 kilometer square, so I have written 8 here. Multiplying precipitation and area values, as you can see, we have got all these values, and here adding all the values of this area, that is summation area equal to 22.9, and here adding all the values of precipitation into A, and finally getting the summation of these values as 168.5. now if putting these values in the Thiessen's polygon method, that is P average equal to summation of precipitation into area divided by summation of area, that is 168.5 divided by summation of area, that is 22.9. We finally got this value as the average mean precipitation is 7.35. So this is the process using Thiessen's polygon method. Hope you all have understood.